Welcome to history class. Now we will see our today's topic. Our today's topic is Jallianwala Bagh incident. The British government passed the infamous Rowlatt Act, which gave enormous powers to the police to arrest any person without any reason or trial. The main purpose of this act was to curb the growing nationalist upsurge in the country. Basically, if you'll see, national sentiments, it were flourished in 1918 to 1922, British government thought that such national sentiments were not good for the Britishers. That is why one act passed on 21st of March 1919. This act was also known as Black Act. Mahatma Gandhi strongly protested against this Black Act. Now we will see what was the outcome, what actually it happened when this particular act it were passed in 1919. Jallianwala Bagh incident, it occurred on 13th of April 1919. Jallianwala Bagh is situated in Amritsar, Punjab. Dr. Satyapal and Saifuddin Kichlu, these two Congress leaders, were arrested on 10th April 1919. And secretly, these two leaders were deported to Dharamsala just to hold a protest movement against such incident. Basically, this deportation of these two leaders and the Rowlatt Act. One mass gathering, it happened in Jallianwala Bagh on 13th April. A good number of people were assembled on 13th April. There were two reasons. First of all, on that particular day, there was a festival of Baisakhi in Punjab. And secondly, the deportations of those two leaders were must be protested. Thus, having these two aims, a good number of people, they assembled in Jallianwala Bagh. General O. Dyer, military commander in the British rule, he came to know such incident and he locked down the whole Bagh. And nearly 1,650 bullets were fired. On unarmed civilians, nearly 1,500 people injured and more than 1,000 people died in this vicious terror, which it were created by General O. Dyer. Ultimately, Rabindranath Tagore gave up his knighthood as per the protest against this Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Gandhiji also astonished by seeing such barbaric attitudes of the Britishers, and just to hold protest, a good number of people make further strike and hartals all over India. One thing we must remember that in Jallianwala, only one entrance there, and that particular entrance, it were blocked by General O. Dyer. No warning is given to the unarmed civilians who gathered in Jallianwala Bagh. He opened fire for nearly 10 minutes until the ammunition not finished. Thus, we can say the Jallianwala Bagh massacre was really a cruel act which initiated by General O. Dyer. Now, in next video, you will be able to see the Chauri Chaura incident. Thank you for watching.